I've played my account for 5,784 hours without dying once, and I have 36 out of 56 unique drops from the wilderness. So I'm currently ranked 24 with 223 kills at RTO, and this is the absolutely genius strategy I found out about in the last episode. By using the Thamron Scepter with Blood Barrage and Blood Bark, I can stand by the entrance at all times, giving PKs absolutely zero chance. So I managed to get the Tyrannical Ring, but there's two more rares to go. Yep, not even a chance. Oh, I'll be seeing you later, Chief.
One kill and he's already back. This place is actually stupidly active.
I'm not going to complain that the wilderness is active. This is good. 250 kill count. As you can see, the drops from this place are very good for the account. Okay, actually got TB'd. Ah, that is my mistake. I should not be getting hit here. As long as I pay attention, it's impossible. Oh. Okay, interesting. Gotta be very careful not to get stacked out from full HP. And there's the Chaos Talisman escape. Easy. Another PK. And that is the big 300 KC. And the first trip, I've actually managed to fill the entire looting bag. 1.2 mil. 98 magic, I didn't even realize. One more to go, and I'll be taking the extra magic defense. And that's 312 KC, now up to rank 19. It's looking like climbing up the ranks is going to be a lot slower now. RM's guy, I'll be seeing you later. Damn it, I wanted to finish the kill. He's probably going to get the freeze here. Someone actually told me that these trees I can run around, and I can just get gap. You can't run through the trees, so let's just do Ringa Ringa Roses. We could do this all day. Well, I guess maybe until I run out of run energy, I guess. All right, let's get out of here. And that is the second Dragon Two-Hander. Finally hit the rare drop table again. I've had a lot of people ask me why I don't use an account to wait outside the cave to scout. And while I have used other accounts for protection in the past when I was at Scorpio, that was a bit different. That was above 30 wilderness in multi, can't log out, can't teleport, can't do anything. I mean, scouts are okay. I mean, it's not against the rules at all. I just feel like it would take away a lot of the risk. There's also a plugin which flashes the entire screen as soon as it sees a player. I do use player indicators, which puts the name on the mini map, but that is pretty much essential. It would be absolutely suicide not to use it because sometimes you actually can't see the white dot. But flashing the entire screen, I feel like, is going a bit too far. And again, it just takes away like all the risk. And also, it's just really sad and just low to use it for your sponsor transition. I actually have something I know every single one of you are going to love, and that is the RuneScape resin cast figures made by Chrom, a fellow RuneScape content creator. Well, he kind of left us all in the bin. I mean, look at him. He's absolutely smashing it. They are absolutely perfect to have at your desk. They're such good quality and so heavy, especially this General Grador. I'm so surprised. It's so well made. And in case you don't believe me, well, it won a Golden Gnome, so I think that says it all. And in case you're still not sure, well, check out all the 5-star reviews. They're made in small batches and they sell out really fast. The Giant Mole is currently out of stock, but this is the first restock since last Christmas. So I would get them while they are available. And there's currently a Ziliana, which is a new release, and they're currently working on Callisto and the Rocky Pair. And I have a massive discount of 20% off if you use code Torvesta. Go to the link in the description. And thank you very much to Chrom for sponsoring the video. I am out of runes. That is 355 KC. And a very good trip. One mil. Let's make some cash. I still have a memory in my brain of discovering high alchemy for the first time. I thought it was absolutely mesmerizing that this guy was turning items into cash. I'm going through far too many escape crystals by accidentally teleporting, but that is another 10. I mean, 100% worth it. The best update for hardcore men ever. There we go. That's over 7k bloods. 364 KC. That is rank 18 now. The Toad Fox drops are so good. That is 45 brews right there. That's a full trip completed. 765k. 400 kill count. That is going to do for now because I really need to focus on the Zora grind. The blowpipe is just going to transform this account. I mean, I've got over 200,000 amethyst darts in the bank waiting to be used. And as soon as I get it, I'm camping revenants for the other two best in slot revenant weapons, the crossbow and the chain mace. So I've killed 300 Zora up to now. I've got 2 onyxes and 1 magic fang.
No.
No. Jar of Swarm, what does that do again? 1 in 3,000 drop rate. Apparently I get a boss display in the POH. To be fair, I didn't have anything in there before, so yeah, I'll take that.
I just look back in this clip. Zora throws a ranged attack on my 39 HP. I heal the exact same time he hits me a 40. That's 90 fletching. I can now make dragon arrows and amethyst darts. I actually have a lot of dragon arrow tips from the Laren's chest. That's almost 4k dragon arrows. Who knows, one day we'll get a T-bow, hopefully. Speaking of fletching, I have had these longbows in the bank for the longest time since I AFK'd to 99 woodcutting, and I've actually been waiting until I did Zora before I did anything about them because of the 1000 flax drops. There's absolutely no way I am making these into bowstring myself, but what I can do is the Kandarin Elite Diary. I actually have all the requirements.
86 herb blow requirement, absolutely no problem.
So I need to kill some mythril dragons. I'm looking for some chewed bones, which is a 1 in 40 to drop rate. Beautiful, there's the two bones. 10 hours of barbarian assault, or I just stand by the cannon and get some editing done and do it in less than half the time.
Thank you to BA Services, you can do the same, join the CC or Dust Guild.
Constructor Pyreship completed, and that's the Kandarin Diary fully completed. That is 50,000 per XP, and now every single day I can exchange 250 flax for 250 bowstring. Next, I am going to do the easy, medium, and hard Fremenite Diary. You'll see why. There we go, Fremenite Hard Diary completed. A Great Brain Robbery that unlocks the Harmony Island teleport. So I've been mining a lot of salt, and that unlocks the 9th herb patch and 750 stony and icy basalt teleports. I now actually have every single item and diary completed for the maximum herb yield on herb runs. On average, I should get about 86 herbs per run. I've not done them in a very long time, but I do plan to max this account as long as I don't die. Once I actually plant all these seeds, I am actually gonna have 99 herb lot banked. 100 days ago, I put 7.5 mil in the kingdom. Obviously, nobody remembers to get favor every single day, but I tried my best. 25k coal. The ore supply is looking strong. 77 agility, and that's 7.5 mil cash. And that's going straight back into the kingdom, but this time I am putting it on maple logs. You can actually AFK firemaker now by using logs on a fire, but you only get a third of the XP. But if there's a brand new opportunity to AFK a skill, I am taking it. Anyway, slight little detour back to Zora. Would you look at that? I could be the first PvPer to 500k subscribers.
Oh! Can you stop with the pop-ups?
A new personal best though, 1 minute 12. That's 100 more kills, 400kc, and sadly, no drops. Let's see if I can get lucky at Barrows and get an arms piece.
Already got one of them.
Darok's plate body, that's a unique. Does that complete the set? Actually does. I have full Darok's. Maybe that could be useful, you never know. Another item, Guthan's plate body, already got that.
No, the Guthan spear.
The best drop if this was 2015. In case you're curious, I'm not even far from completing Barrows.
Torag's helm, another duplicate,
and that's the 350th chest.
No, the duplicate Guthan spear. Damn it.
How much are we talking for a Guthan spear? I remember back in the day, 6 mil.
Right then.
Another Dark's plate body.
Back to back. Guthan's plate body.
Another duplicate. And this will be the last chest. 400kc. Still no Aram's piece. The last time I did Slayer was when I got the trident, so I still have some krakens left to finish.
I'm going to do the boss in the hopes that I get the kraken tentacle. You never know. A second Trident of the Seas. Is that useful at all to have a second?
No.
Task completed. Sadly, no tentacle. I'm going to return to Wilderness Slayer, which I'm not looking forward to, in the hopes to get a Revenant or a Bear Task now.
I'm going to buy the Like a Boss Slayer reward as well. Lesser demons.
Ugh. Off we go to the Wilderness Slayer cave. Here we go. If I get caught here, I'm giving myself a 10% survival rate. Basically just depends how many people they brought. Lesser demons completed and no Laren's keys.
Oh, I was so slow there. Got the teleport, that's the main thing. And that's exactly why we stand where we stand.
Going back for the cannon. I've got the cannon.
Iron's key, finally. There we go. It has been a while since I've seen one of them. Another one gets in. There is the second. Greater demons completed. Nice.
The good thing is that I can be very, very flexible because of all these points I've got.
Yeah, I'm even going to skip Enquiries. They're terrible XP.
Skeletons, might as well pick up the points.
Zombies, more easy points. Oh my! Huh! I was trying to find the ground markers plugin so I know where to put the cannon. Just teleport away from a bone crossbow green D-eyed pleb.
Lawrence Key, very nice. Ice Shines completed. That's now 220 wilderness tasks. Another easy point task. Oh, yes. Two lesser demons left. The key to save the day. And task completed. I just seem to be getting the same tasks. That's a Lawrence Key, but I'm not gonna lie. I think these may have to be a skip. It's just such a waste of cannonballs for a very slim chance of a Lawrence Key. Ice Shines completed. Dust Devils, yes. Finally, a barrageable task.
Mate, what on earth? Why was someone there?
He was stood there by the teleport spot, and I have been in that world for a while, so it's very possible someone scouted me.
Well, I just got well and truly shafted. One Lawrence Key in 308 kills. Right. Another lesser demon task, and that's a Lawrence Key.
Lovely teleport.
He wasn't a peeker, but yeah, obviously still got to be done.
I've got 15 left. Let's make this quick.
Nice. There we go. Task completed.
And that is a key early on. Hopefully this can be a good task.
No, it was a pure. Damn it.
No chance. Ah, too genius with where I stand. It's safe to say I'm getting scammed by Laren. That's greater demons completed.
That is what I like to see. Now we're talking, that is the third. This very lengthy task is actually paying off. That's four.
Blood demons completed.
Dust devils, get it.
Laren's key number one, and we have a superior here.
In case you need to be reminded, has a guaranteed Laren's key drop. So that's number two.
Laren's key number three, and another superior spawns. They all locked in at the same time. That was a coordinated attack.
Why they landed in Mystics?
I want to go and pick up my cannon. I've given it like 5 minutes.
I don't know, mate. This is so risky. I want to finish the task. Right, okay. No one's there for now. I'm scared. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. I'm so scared. Got the cannon. Log out. Right. Can I finish the task? That is the question.
Lawrence key number five. Let's go. Yes, that is a third superior. Nice. That is a seventh.
The fourth superior?
That's eight keys.
Oh, yes.
And we're out of here. Nice. Well, that's made up for all the terrible tasks. The first key opening in a very long time. In case you need reminding. Yeah, that's seven Dagonai hats. No other pieces. It is very much possible that I could just complete Dagonai right here, right now, and I'll never have to return to Wilderness Slayer ever again.
Well, back to Wilderness Slayer we go. That's a nice amount of iron ore and steel bars though for the cannonballs. Really good.
Scorpions completed. Oh, mate. First greater demon kill. Lawrence key.
Key number two.
230 tasks in a row.
Scorpions.
Chaos druids. Nice. We have got a chance of getting the elder pieces. I have zero so far.
Lawrence key.
Yes. I'm not gonna lie, I'm so tempted to just go in the middle and kill them because this is stupidly slow.
My reaction times are gonna have to be lightning quick, but this is just so much quicker. My cannon's hitting all of them and I can use an MSB.
Wow. He could have actually attacked me.
I'm not too sure about this anymore. I'm kind of scared.
Why is there a max combat guy peeking at Elder Chaos Druids? Surely there's better things to do with the time. And sadly, still no Elder Piece. Let's see if the look's any different at Zora.
I'm out of Cosmic Runes, and I have been runecrafting with absolutely no food at the abyss. But I have just made a discovery. You can actually runecraft not in the wilderness, and it's actually faster by using the fire ring in my house. And also, I don't have to use stamina pots because I can use the ornate pool. That is 3,000 cosmics.
What the...
That was a bit dodgy. I am completely out of arrows. Luckily, this stock of amethyst is not a problem. 1.5k arrows, there we go.
Yes, yes! Yes! Oh my god, I've got it! I've got the Tanzanite Fang just before 500kc.
The Magic Shortbow era has officially ended, and the Toxic Blowpipe chapter has officially begun. It's safe to say things are about to get a whole lot more interesting, and I am very excited.